Within a short span of time, the platform has become synonymous with original storytelling.
I'm stuck only because of you. Chance se mar bhi nahi sakta kya?
तुम दोनों की माँ को मैंने फ्री कर दिया।
Powerful short films with unique storylines.
Hello, 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 hello.
To create a perfect short film, you have to put the right step in the process of making a film.
It is your voice, it is your point of view.
Every story gets the respect.
This is the best platform for every newcomer.
An evening packed with powerful conversations with renowned actors and filmmakers.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to a night of cinema and conversation. Royal Stag Barrel Select Large Short Film, centered on the theme of Make It Perfect, is India's premier online hub for shorts. The platform has collaborated with some of the most established names in the business, but it's also the preferred destination for aspiring filmmakers. Within a short span of time, the platform has become synonymous with original and powerful storytelling, and it has helped to establish shorts as a credible genre in the country. Tonight, we're going to be talking about the importance of short films and the road movie. It gives me great pleasure to introduce you to our esteemed panelists. The accomplished director, Zoya Akhtar. The talented actor, Randeep Hooda. The fabulous Malika Dua, who is now an actor starring in Nawab. The storyteller, director and writer known for her acclaimed short films, Mansi Jain. The director of today's short film, Adheen, Yash Varma. The brilliant actor starring in Adheen, Neeraj Purohit. Welcome, everybody.
Thank you.
And Zoya, I, of course, want to start with you. Why is the road movie in which a character goes through a journey, both literal and metaphorical, such a popular format, such a popular way of telling a story, not just in India, but around the globe?
I think like any kind of trip, especially a road trip if you've taken one, is in itself an extremely cathartic experience. You know, when do you sit still in a place and stare? When do you spend that kind of time, even if you're with a companion, hours where you're not speaking? There is a certain sense of passage that happens, which that it leads to a catharsis. So I think that it is something that really connects with people. I mean, besides the fact that you have different experiences, a landscape keeps changing, you know, there's a lot to look out for. And yeah, but I feel like the core of it is we all have a journey somewhere that changed you, you know? And I think that's what people relate to.
Randeep, what does the format do for an actor? Does it offer a sort of unique experience because you're creating a film as you move from one place to another?
Apart from the changing scenery, the food, and rather inconvenient, you know, after hours, I think it's the same. What I found fascinating about the only road movie that I've done, which is Highway, what I found very fascinating about it was that there are only two Indias, the haves and the have-nots, the rich and the poor. So I found that very fascinating, that between mine and Alia's character, the point of view towards the world, and how that changes through the journey, that was our internal journey, that this one becomes that and that one becomes this. I didn't like the ending so much, but I found it very fascinating to explore the two sides.
Mansi and Malika, let's talk about Nawab. Such a lovely little story. Mansi, where did it come from? Is it a real incident that inspired it?
It's something that bothers me a lot, that how easily people abandon animals, and like, they're not cute anymore. A lot of the dialogues that you hear are things I've heard when I've volunteered at shelters or like helped out people. But the other story that I was toying with was people were splitting up all around me, and other like friends were super invested in their relationship, and they're like, who do we pick? Who do we go with? So obviously, like, if it's a kid, it's a little more like darker, and it's very black and white. If you don't want, if one of them doesn't want to take a kid, I was like, wait, what if it's a dog that neither of them want? So it became a mash of the two.
Malika, are you an animal lover as well? Is that what brought you into the film? Why did you do it?
I am an animal lover, but then I eat them also because I love them so much. I don't know where I stand with this.
You're conflicted. It's complicated.
It's very complicated. It's a very complicated relationship. It was just that I really liked the script. And I knew Mansi really wanted to tell that story. And I liked every character in it. And I wasn't playing the clown. So I was like, yes, I want to do this.
Yash, where did Adheen come from? What does that name? What does the title mean?
Adheen means to be dependent. So if you're dependent on someone, it means to be dependent. So that's where Adheen comes from. Adheen started off as a theater play. So it was a short play with Neeraj. Neeraj actually co-wrote the project. And so he gave me a narration. I said, great. Went and watched the play. Liked it, but there were many changes. So we went through a whole process where we took out about 20 pages in the script, because as a theater audience, something works, and on screen, that might not work at all. So it took a while, but finally put it together, and that's where it is right now.
Neeraj, can you tell us more about the origins of the idea for Adheen?
This started a few years back. So I had a rod implant surgery in my leg, and I was in the hospital. My sister, parents were continuously looking after me. And it was a really painful surgery. Like, I told my sister to just move my leg. So she just touched it and I was shouting in pain. So this question came to me that right now I can tell her that it's paining, don't touch it or move it a little bit like that. What if I'm not able to tell her, how long would she look after me? So this question really stayed with me for years, and then I discussed with my co-writer, and then it originated, and I really wanted to ask this question to everyone, that how long can you keep that relationship alive if it's not reciprocated?
So yeah, with your characters, from Luck by Chance to Gully Boy, there's a similar sort of theme of looking for self-expression, looking for freedom. Why does this theme sort of attract you? Why do you keep going back to this?
I find those stories are the most, the arc most interesting. And maybe on some level, I think growing up, I was not ever part of the herd. You know, I think I was always like, I mean, we were brought up to just be a little more authentic to who we were. And if we didn't fit in, we didn't fit in. And I think that was kind of encouraged in my family to be who you are, even if you don't fit in, it's fine.
So it's not by design?
No, it's not by design. I just write that way. Also, the stories I grew up that I loved as a teenager were like a Dead Poet Society, Breakfast Club. They were all about being you. And I think it's just something I like. Yeah.
Randeep, we keep hearing stories about your process and how you become characters. And some of them are very extreme prep stories, like the weight loss for Sarabjit. Why is it necessary to put yourself through so much?
Physical transformation, I think, is the easiest part. But it does give you a lot. Like, for example, in Sarabjit, the reason I did it was that when I was reading the script and this is what we're going to do, the actual Sarabjit had actually put on a lot of weight. So I said, okay, but what the screenplay is trying to say is a very pathetic state of affairs that he was in. So I discussed it with Umang and we decided to cut the weight. And I was 95 kilos. So from that, I had to go to a more extreme to get to that point. But when I did get to that point, it did give me a sense of how that guy was in a dark cell for 18 years. He was shackled even in the cell, on his hands and his arms and his legs. So when I started doing that, I started doing it in the bathroom. So I lie in the shower and I won't flush the toilet. I don't know if it's appeasing or not. Because that was one of the things that was mentioned in the script, that, you know, there's a bucket of shit in his thing. So that kind of started giving me senses of smell, of claustrophobia. So those little things start, you know, then guiding you as to what it is. But what I find most difficult is the mental and emotional change that you have to bring about So they're very, very every script, every role, there is no process or method or anything. It just presents itself, and you just hope that it engages you for the length of the shooting. That's all.
We need to take a break here, but don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with more conversation on short films and road movies. Welcome back to Royal Stag Barrel Select Large Short Films. Let's jump right back into our conversation about short films and road movies. Malika, for you as a performer, do you bear yourself more when you're performing comedy or as an actor?
Now I'm just starting to feel that comedy just takes a lot out of you, you know, a lot, especially if you're not feeling particularly comic at the moment. So I think not doing comedy is easier. Not to say that it's
so playing
tougher.
A character is easier.
Easier as in, I think it's mentally easier. I feel I'm more, like I'm happier when I'm not supposed to kind of play the fool now at this point.
Mansi, did you have to give her a long brief for Nawab, or did she seamlessly get into the role?
I didn't want her to be like the funny girl. I wanted her to look like Sonal Yadav. The brief to the costume, makeup, everyone, and to her also was like, not to play the comedy. Don't try to get laugh. But she was actually really professional. She was like, I hate to say it, but she was amazing in the sense, like, she knew her lines. I was like, what? She knows all her lines? And she, like, that was amazing for me.
Why? Is that surprising?
It is. Unfortunately, it is sometimes surprising.
Zoya, does that happen? Are you surprised when actors know their lines?
No, I've been very blessed. I've worked with very
actors
professional actors. I've
it's
heard
true.
Of actors that come to set and don't know their lines.
Yeah.
They don't do their homework.
I don't like actors who learn their lines, like go to their lines. You
but
know?
If you...
It becomes
no.
a certain thing about it. I know what I'm going to say. I know everything. I know the situation. I've done my homework. But homework does not mean ratta maar ke aajao yaar lines ka. It is more about understanding him.
Okay, let's talk about casting. Yash, Mansi, Zoya, how do you know that you've got the right actor? How do you do it?
Like for me, if the core of the character, I can see the core of the character.
In the actor?
In the actor, I'll work around the physical. I mean, it can't be so radically different that I can't do anything with it. But if it's like here, there, I don't care. I'll tweak the character to fit the core.
I have often found that, you know, if I'm cast in this particular role, I'll try and be that role as close as I can. Instead of somebody casting, seeing something in me and then saying, okay, because it's something they've already seen or something. Very few people can see an essence. Maybe Zoya is one of them. Maybe Imtiaz is one of them who can see an essence of a person and cast them and then make them like that. But most people go by what they have seen, which I find highly boring.
Malsi, how do you find characters? Like you said, you cast Malika because it was against the grain. Is that where you begin from, that I'll cast the person who you least expect?
I go by meeting people, seeing how they do, they read the same thing in the script that I am trying to achieve. Are they finding things in it and taking it to, you know, escalating it to another level, elevating the script? Do they identify with the character and can they act?
Neeraj, it was interesting to me that you left the ending of Adheen ambiguous.
Yeah.
Why did you choose not to tell us what happens?
I don't think anyone has the answer unless you're actually in the situation. So.
Yeah, it's a tough
one. And it is a pretty difficult thing, you know.
You know, I was also thinking that it's perhaps the format, the short film format that allows for things like this. Tell me, how do you all think this is changing the way we tell stories? You know, not just short films, but also original streaming shows. We're no longer caught in the Friday Kitna Hua trap. What is it doing to all of you as artists?
I mean, the main things that have happened is with different formats and different platforms is suddenly there is a space for all your ideas. You know, because there are some ideas that are features, there are some ideas that shouldn't be features because they don't hold. And they're just necessarily a 20-minute, half-an-hour movie or 10 minutes. There are some ideas that actually need 8 to 10 episodes, you know? So suddenly all your ideas have a slot and they're viable. Second thing is, because there's no box office and there's only reviews, I think the audience is suddenly going back to when we were growing up, which was just reacting to the work. You know, they're not guessing what it is. They're not being dictated by numbers. They're being dictated by what they like and the quality of the work, which is what it should be. And the third thing is that there is no censorship. So you're actually completely free. So I think these three things coming together is going to definitely evolve and change a palette. And there will be home and room for all kinds of stories, all kinds of narratives, all kinds of budgets. And there isn't a better world than that for the industry. It's amazing.
It is amazing. Yash, what does it do for somebody who's starting out? There are platforms like Royal Stag that support this ecosystem. What does that do for you as a new filmmaker?
What it does is, first of all, it gives you opportunity to showcase what you can do, okay? Secondly, like, you can experiment with any sort of subject that you want. And like she said, that there's no censorship. So that truly just gives you freedom to tomorrow talk about any subject that you want to talk about.
Mansi, do you think we're finally at the point where the short film is a destination in itself, or is it still a stepping stone?
I think it was always a destination in itself. Like you said, it's a purest form of making films. No one was throwing money at you to do it. No one was dying to be in your short film. And you know, like that, but people were literally doing crowdfunding to get it done. So you're doing it because you want to do it and you're putting everything you have in it.
We need to take another break, but don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Royal Stag Barrel Select Large Short Films. Let's resume our conversation on the importance of short films and road movies. All right, last question, and I'd like all of you to answer it. What's the one change you want to see in the entertainment business in 2020?
I think the award shows suck, you know. I think they're done for TV, and I don't think that they give enough respect to the technical crew. I feel they don't give enough respect to people that make the films, you know, and if they're going to do it and if they're going to award people that make the movies, then they should respect it. I think that's one thing I'd pick for now.
Sandeep?
Now that with the advent of social media and all that, it is changing. It felt to me that only a few people knew art. Only a few people knew what was cool or in or pushing the boundaries. I think it should spread out a bit more.
Malika?
Not one thing, but quite a few things.
Everything.
Where do I everything, start? Everything. But I think to begin with, this whole thing of casting based on networking, it just drives me insane, where you just have to have coffee and drinks with someone for them to be able to see that you can do something. I'm like, I can't do this. Main to karungi nahi. I wish we had more like mid-budget films again. Like, I feel like we've gone into a territory which happened in the West a while ago, where it was either the Avengers kind of a thing or like Sundance films. And like, there were no middle films that didn't have the pressure of making insane amounts of money on Friday. I wish like there's room for like Dam Laga Ke Hai Sha and stuff again. It's not a one-off. Like,
I think the mainstream Bollywood blockbusters, they need like better writers to come through, more character study, okay, more to think about, because I think writing is the crux of every good film, and I think that should be explored more, and probably writers should be paid more. Yeah, so that's where the change is going to come about.
Neeraj, last word to you.
I would like the cinema to be more authentic. Like, the authenticity is somewhere going down. In a way, like, I wouldn't name the films, but it has become like a masala recipe. I would really wish that something new, something organic should come out instead of just trying to create a curry out of it.
Can I add one thing to it?
Please.
I think in 2020 there should be more movies like Gully Boy.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
It was authentic. It had feeling. It did well with the audience.
Yeah. It was entertaining.
And it is by far one of the best films made in Indian cinema so far. And it really touched me. Apna time aayega, boys. Yeah. And thank you, Zoya, for it.
Thank you.
And that's it's really heartfelt. I saw it and I was
thank
like,
you.
Hey, it was real. It is authentic. It's got all these things.
Absolutely.
Yet, it touches people and reeks in the moolah. Eh?
Thank you.
That's the best kind of movie.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
You know, a good film that does well.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you for being such wonderful panelists.
Thank you so much.
I hope you enjoyed that as much as I did. Thank you to Royal Stag Battle Select Large Short Films for choosing such wonderful movies. And thank you to our venue partner, the Roshanara Club. From all of us, it's good night.